Hello everybody. So in this important oxidizing reagents for competitive examination, so in the second part, so I'm going to discuss the applications of pyridinium chlorochromate, pyridinium dichromate, manganese dioxide and ozone. So PCC, this is pyridinium chlorochromate, so pyridinium chromium based pyridinium complex, and this can be used for the selective oxidation of primary alcohols into aldehydes. So this is a primary alcohols, it can be oxidized into aldehydes in the presence of a PCC, and it can be used to oxidize secondary alcohols into ketones. So this is secondary alcohol, it can be oxidized into ketones. The commonly used solvent is dichloromethane, CH2Cl2. It's a DCM, and look at this. So this is a primary hydroxyl group. So in the presence of pyridinium chlorochromate and DCM, so this group can be oxidized into an aldehyde. So primary alcohol into aldehyde, and look at this. So this is secondary alcohol groups. So this secondary alcohol can be oxidized into ketone in the presence of PCC. So this secondary hydroxyl groups can be oxidized into a ketone. And the oxidation of tertiary allylic alcohols, look at this. So this is a tertiary hydroxyl group, and this is tertiary allylic alcohols in the presence of pyridinium chlorochromate. So there is a rearrangement reaction takes place and can get the alpha, beta unsaturated carbonyl compound as a product. So oxidative cationic cyclization, so look at this example. So this is a primary hydroxyl group. So the first step, it can be oxidized into an aldehyde, and there is a possibility of in type of reactions, and you can get the cyclized product, and this is a secondary hydroxyl group. This can be further oxidized into a ketone. So there is a possibility of oxidative cationic cyclization. And similarly, this example also, so this is a primary hydroxyl group. So the first step, it can be oxidized into aldehyde, and there is a possibility of in reaction to get the cyclized product. Similarly, this example also, you can get alpha, beta unsaturated carbonyl compound as the product. And the oxidation of enol ethers. So here, this position can be oxidized into a keto group, that is, this is a lactones, that is a cyclic esters. And look at this, so this is a six membered ring, you can get lactones as a product in the presence of PCC and DCM. And the oxidation of active methylene group, so here, so this is active methylene group, so because this CH2, so adjacent to electronegative atom, and this group can be oxidized into a keto group. Similarly here also, so this CH2 group can be oxidized into C keto group. So this is oxidation of active methylene group in the presence of pyridinium chlorochromate. And the next reagent is a PDC, so pyridinium dichromate. So this is a pyridinium dichromate. So this is John Conforth, he utilized this reagent for the conversion of for the oxidation of alcohols. He got Nobel Prize in 1975 for his work on the stereochemistry of enzyme catalyzed reactions. And this can be used for selective oxidation of primary and secondary alcohols. Especially, so there is a selective oxidation of allylic alcohol in the presence of other hydroxyl groups. So here, so this is a primary hydroxyl group. So in the presence of PDC and DCM, so this group can be oxidized into an aldehyde group. So PDC is less acidic than pyridinium chlorochromate, and hence PDC, it's a pyridinium dichromate, is more suitable in the oxidation of acid sensitive substrates. So this the oxidation product also depends on the solvent used here. So chromium trioxide, pyridine and water is known as Con4th reagent, and PDC in DMF, that is a dimethyl formamide, then it is known as Corey-Schmidt reagent. So non-conjugated alcohol, so in the presence of pyridinium dichromate and DCM, dichloromethane, you can get aldehyde as a product, but in the presence of dimethyl formamide, you can get carboxylic acid as a product. But in the case of conjugated alcohols, so the primary alcohols oxidize into aldehyde in the presence of dichloromethane, and even in the presence of dimethyl formamide, you can get aldehyde as a product. But in the case of non-conjugated alcohol, if you change the solvent, you can get the different products. If it is dichloromethane, then you will get aldehyde as a product. If it is dimethyl formamide, then you will get carboxylic acid as a product. So non-conjugated alcohol, look at this example here. So this is a primary alcohol. It can be oxidized into carboxylic acid in the presence of DMF. But in the presence of dichloromethane, you can get aldehyde as a product. So here similarly, this is a non-conjugated alcohol because there is no conjugation. So this hydroxyl group can be oxidized into carboxylic acid group in the presence of dimethyl formamide. And in the case of conjugated alcohols, even in the presence of dimethyl formamide, you can get aldehyde as a product. So look at this example. This is benzyl alcohol. In the presence of dimethyl formamide, you can get aldehyde only as a product. And here, this is allylic alcohol. So this, in the presence of DMF, you can get aldehyde as a product. So only for non-conjugated alcohol, the solvents plays a major role. But in the case of conjugated alcohol, you will end up aldehyde as a product, even if you are using DMF or DCM. And acid sensitive substrates like enol ethers and epoxides, they are not affected during the oxidation of oxidation with the PDC. You can look at this. So this group is acid sensitive group, but it cannot be affected by the presence of PDC. Only this CH2OH can be oxidized into CHO. And this epoxide rings, you can see, this will not be affected by the presence of PDC. You can get this CH2OH into CHO. And the next reagent is manganese dioxide, M1O2. So this can be used for the selective oxidation of allylic and benzylic alcohols to aldehydes or ketones. And the configuration of the double bond is conserved during the oxidation reaction of M1O2. Look at this. And this is allylic hydroxyl group. So in the presence of manganese dioxide, you can get aldehyde as a product. And this is also, you can see, allylic hydroxyl group can be oxidized into an aldehyde group. So this MnO2 is selectively used for the oxidation of allylic or benzylic hydroxyl groups. So it will not affect the other hydroxyl groups. Here, so this is another example. This allylic hydroxyl groups can be oxidized into aldehyde. And similarly, this example also. And look at this here, you can see two hydroxyl groups. So as I said earlier, so manganese dioxide selectively oxidizes only benzylic. So this group is benzylic hydroxyl, and you can get this CH2OH can be oxidized into CHO. So this group will not be affected. Similarly, benzyl alcohol, you can get benzaldehyde as the product in the presence of manganese dioxide. Look at this example. Here you can see three hydroxyl groups. So which one will get oxidized in the presence of manganese dioxide? Yeah. So this allylic hydroxyl groups can be oxidized into a ketone. So these two groups will not be affected. Okay. And similarly, so in the presence of manganese dioxide, potassium cyanide and methanol, you can see this is alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde. And this transformations of benzylic or alpha beta unsaturated, this position is alpha and this is beta. So this alpha beta unsaturated aldehydes into corresponding methyl esters. So this reaction is known as Corey-Gilman-Ganem oxidation. So look at this example here. So in the whenever you see the manganese dioxide and cyanide source, that is it may be potassium cyanide or sodium cyanide, and in the presence of alcohols, you can get the corresponding ester as the product. So the first step is the nucleophilic addition of a cyanide ion, and here so this hydroxyl groups can be oxidized into ketone, and the last step in the presence of alcohol you can get ester as a product. Similarly, in this example also we can see this allylic hydroxyl groups can be oxidized and to give the corresponding esters in the presence of manganese dioxide, potassium cyanide and ethanol. So the configuration of the double bond is conserved, as I said earlier. You can see in the reactant Z, in the product as well as Z. Z isomer, in this example also E isomer, E isomer. And this hydroxyl group, that is allylic hydroxyl group, can be oxidized into a keto group. So ozonolysis, look at this. This can be used for the cleavage of carbon-carbon double bond to give carbonyl compounds or alcohols, depend on the workup conditions. So it may be reductive workup or oxidative workup. So the intermediate is ozonide, and usually the reactions occur at very low temperature, and the common solvents are dichloromethane or methanol. So here the electron donating groups in carbon-carbon double bond enhances the rate of ozonolysis. So we'll see. And in the reductive workup, so the reducing reagents used are catalytic hydrogenations, sulfate ion, phosphine. So these are all the common reducing agents. So out of this, dimethyl sulfide is used most commonly for reductive workup. If I use these reducing agents, then you will end up aldehydes or ketone as the product. If I use lithium aluminum hydride or sodium borohydride in reductive workup, you can get alcohols as a product. In the oxidizing reagent, you can see, so these are all oxidizing reagents can utilize for oxidative workup. Out of this, peroxides can be used most commonly for oxidizing agents in the oxidative workup conditions. And you will get the product carboxylic acids. Look at this, the first, this is ozonide. You can get carbonyl compound as a product. So it can follow 3 plus 2 cycloaddition reaction. So ozonide is the intermediate. In the, if it is oxidative workup, look at this. So first step is ozonolysis. So the second step is oxidative workup. Here they have used hydrogen peroxide, and you can get carboxylic acid as a product. And in the reductive workup, you can see sodium sulfite. So you can get aldehyde as a product. So the cyclic alkenes become chains here. So this bond can be cleaved in the presence of ozone, and the second step is the dimethyl sulfide reductive workup. You can get aldehyde as a product. So this is a reductive workup, and the rate of ozonolysis. So as I said earlier, so electron rich carbon-carbon double bonds will undergo ozonolysis at a faster rate. Here methoxy groups are electron donating, methyl groups, here methyl groups, here methyl groups. And look at this, here only 4 methyl groups. So this is the decreasing order of rate of ozonolysis of different alkenes. And electron rich carbon-carbon double bonds undergo ozonolysis at a faster rate. Look at this example. You can see these two positions, but if I use 1 micron of ozone, this will undergo ozonolysis at a faster rate. Look at this, if it is dimethyl sulfide, you can get aldehydes. If it is hydrogen peroxide, carboxylic acid. If it is sodium borohydride, you can get alcohols as a product. This is different reductive and oxidative workup conditions. And the hindered alkenes always give epoxides. No, you can see epoxide as the products for hindered alkenes. And this is the example asked in CSR examinations. So thank you so much.